Hello and welcome to Linux This Month. We have a lot of news to talk about this month, including some big releases from Ubuntu, Windows 11 versus Windows performance benchmarking, some great news for gaming in Linux, and a cool Linux-based Raspberry Pi project. But first, let's jump into the top stories. Ubuntu 21.10, Impish Indri, has been released. The latest version of Ubuntu brings exciting new software, such as GNOME version 40 and the 5.13-based kernel. It also features the latest Firefox version 93 as a snap. There are a few small visual differences in GNOME 40, such as the dock being moved to the bottom of the screen, as well as rounded corners on Windows. There's also an activities overview that shows your workspaces organized horizontally. Now, multiple workspaces have been around for decades, but Canonical is putting a new twist on it. Because they're horizontal and you can bring them up with a hotkey, this enables you to switch between workspaces easily. This is helpful for software developers, for instance, who keep debug screens up while the IDE is on the other screen. It can also be helpful for media production, when you need to organize your workspaces to match your process. Wayland is a default display server in Ubuntu, and it has some changes too. It now has advanced support for NVIDIA users, which means more performance and benefits for folks gaming on Linux. For those who are putting Ubuntu on a Raspberry Pi, there's some additional community support, and Ubuntu Impish Indri will now support the Sense Hat, which is a popular device used for the development of IoT. It supports a number of sensors and has an LED matrix. Now, Windows 11 is out and considered stable. Pharonix ran some tests to see how it stacks up against a few Linux distributions. As it turns out, five Linux distributions outperformed Windows 11 by a good margin. They ran tests and found that Ubuntu 21.10, that we just mentioned, along with Ubuntu 20.04, Arch Linux, Fedora, and Clear Linux, all outperformed Windows 11 on their tests. Clear Linux, which is a distribution built by Intel with performance in mind, made the biggest gains against Windows 11. These gains are focused around the CPU, GPU, and memory. This kind of performance matters when you're gaming in Linux, but it's even more important when you're doing work on your machine, things like compiling, rendering video, or working with AI and ML projects. This extra performance means you can save some valuable time. Now, when Pharonix ran these same tests with Windows 10, the gap was not as wide, meaning you could use Windows or Linux without much difference. But against Windows 11, it shows that using Linux will be a notable change. With this increased performance, we could see more people migrating to Linux for tasks that require better CPU and memory speed. Now, it's worth noting that Windows 11 is brand new, so we can expect they'll work on improving performance and narrowing the gap. If they don't, we may continue to see more migration to the Linux desktop. Redcore Linux is a distribution you probably haven't heard of. The group released version 21.02 Polaris, and it's mostly a bug fix release, but it shows great potential. Why? Because Redcore Linux is based on Gentoo, which focuses on performance and low resource usage. However, Gentoo usually has to be compiled by hand and requires a lot of configuration. Redcore does much of that for you. It's a rolling release system like Gentoo. What this means is you get the latest version of software packages continuously. You don't wait 6 months to a year for a version release of the operating system. Now, this is a trade-off. If you want to use the newest versions of software packages, it can sacrifice stability. KDE, one of the most popular desktop environments for Linux, has recently released a fingerprint authentication feature. This means users can use fingerprint authentication on their machines and enroll as well as de-enroll fingerprints for access. This is great news for folks wanting to secure their Linux machines even further. We talked about Ubuntu 21.02 Impish Indri release, which is Canonical's stable release of Ubuntu. But you can now download the next version, which is in beta. Ubuntu 22.04 Jammy Jellyfish is now available for download. If you would like to test out the bleeding edge version of Ubuntu set to be released next year, check it out. It will feature GNOME 42, which takes some hints from elementary OS. There's a system-wide dark style preference and day and night scheduling options. There are new power profiles available to help you save battery on laptops, and it has a new multitasking panel with hot corners to help you navigate your desktop in a fast and productive manner. The NVIDIA 495.44 stable driver is out for Linux. This is great news for gamers and folks using the GPU for things like video rendering, AI, and ML. You can squeeze out better performance and additional features from your hardware. It has a better Wayland experience, which will be smoother, and they fixed some X server bugs as well. The driver now works with a GBM API, which allows developers to take advantage of the hardware for smoother experiences. The Raspberry Pi is a low-cost way to make your office a smart office, and Montrail did just that. They built a network with Raspberry Pis to control lighting, meeting room occupancy, security for the office doors, and more. They even have color-changing LED lamps in the kitchen, all controlled by Raspberry Pis running Linux. Exciting! And that's it for this month's Linux This Month. If you like the show, be sure to give this episode a big thumbs up. Have a question? Add it into the comments. May your source code remain open and your code compile. See you next time. Subscribe to stay up to date. And keep being awesome, cloud gurus.